Tucked away in the narrow green valleys of Northumberland lies the small village of Edlingham. There are stories to tell from its roots in early Christianity to 300 years of border warfare. Edlingham, Northumberland is a reminder of our past and the great kingdom we all come from. The Anglo-Saxon Church of St. John the Baptist could well be the foundations of the town's early Christianity and would have been used as a refuge in times of need. Edlingham was one of the first Northumbrian villages given to Cuthbert by the King of Northumberland. It may have seemed an important settlement at the time, but little trace of it remains today. I think the reason travelling has such an effect on me is the need to explore the unknown, to be out on the open road and into the wild. Originally built as a small manor house, the castle of Edlingham had to be fortified to protect the village from oncoming Scottish invaders. Edlingham's castle and railway combination is not unique, nor is it particularly rare in rural Britain, but it's a reminder that in warlike times give way to a new kind of conquest, that of industry and modern innovation, which as the abandoned railway station and viaduct reflect, it itself is soon outdated. It's clear this would have been a hard place to live during the Anglo-Scottish Wars. This war-torn land would have scared the hardest of men. For 300 years, medieval Scottish warriors pillaged and fought great battles in the land of Northumberland for the freedom and independence of Scotland. Did hear a great blast of wind go by his window and something fell with a great weight upon his heart and give cry like a cat. There appeared a light at his bed foot, and there he saw the ghost of Margaret Stafford. Margaret Stafford was accused of witchcraft, and it's believed that she haunts the hills of Edlingham to this day. Whatever the truth behind the tales, it's clear this place has a turbulent history. As I head back out into open country, I travel north to a place many religious people have been drawn to for a very long time. It's hard to believe that I'm walking in the footsteps of one of our ancestors and heading to one of the most sacred places on earth, St. Cuthbert's Cave. Northumberland has some of the wildest and most remote areas in Britain. You can walk for miles and not bump into a single person. Yet this land is steeped in thousands of years of history. Northumberland is not just a county. It's the core of the greatest kingdom there ever was. This rural landscape can be harsh and unforgiving, but this place holds very dear to my heart. Walking along Greenshill Hill provides some fascinating views. The landscape here is such a beauty, and it's not difficult to imagine Cuthbert living and meditating here at some time in his life. This isn't an easy place to find, but that's the whole point. Because when we think of caves, we usually think of a place of sanctuary or refuge, where people can take shelter from the oncoming storm. To some, it may seem inhospitable and bleak, but this cave became an important refuge for the monks of Lindisfarne. In 875 AD, Scandinavian Vikings raided and pillaged the holy island of Lindisfarne. The monks fled inland, taking with them their most treasured possessions and the body of St. Cuthbert. Imagine what it would have been like as a monk trying to carry Cuthbert's body to get away from the Vikings. And the stories tell us that the monks travelled around northern England for 8 years carrying Cuthbert's remains. Just imagine that. It's written that on the night St. Aidan died, a young shepherd boy named Cuthbert had a vision of Aidan's body being carried to heaven by angels. Can understand why this would have seemed a good option when escaping from marauding Vikings, but also why you would soon crave more comfortable surroundings. It's amazing to think that this cave became a refuge for someone who had already been dead for 200 years, and as we can still see today, it's pretty bleak and miserable, but the peace and serenity that you get from this place is unlike anything else you'll ever experience. Cuthbert would have longed for solitude. The burdens that he had to carry cemented his name in history. I think the reason I'm doing this is not of fear for religion. It's because I'm a traveller. I'm fascinated by our history and the epic journeys involved.